Hello, good day, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dr. A.B. Katagum, Dental Health Coordinator, Nigerian Medical Association, FCT. Today, we will be discussing on MDCN online registration and remitter payments. Before, we used to fill up the form manually, but do you know now, with the aid of the computer, you can actually register online and make your payment. You can upload your data, CME points, and make your payments through the council website at www.mdcn.gov.ng and remitter website www.remitter.net. For inquiries, you can contact them by email info@mdcn.gov.ng or call the lines. We categorize our doctors into three. Category one, they are those that exist but don't exist, meaning your file is in the MDCN but you don't have an access online. Category two, you exist but you forget to exist. Your file is in the MDCN but you forgot your password, how to log in. Category three, you have your password and you can log in. So let's start with the MDCN website. You visit the website mdcn.gov.ng. You click on sign in on the top left corner. After clicking on sign in, this form will appear. You don't have access online. What you do is you click on first time user. This form will appear. Type in your name, folio number, phone number, and email address. Then you click on submit. The message will appear and an email will be sent to you from the MDCN with your folio number and access to the website. Follow that link and your folio number and full name will appear printed. All you do is you type in a password of your choice. For example, we choose medical, then we click on sign up. Second stage is you have access to MDCN website, but you forgot your password. This time around, you will type in your folio number, but you click on reset password. After you click on reset password, you type in your email and punch the submit button. The email will be sent to your box from MDCN. All you do is you follow this link in blue. After that, you now create another password. Let's say we are putting dental, then we click on reset password. Category three, you now have your folio number and you have your password. What we are going to do now is to log in to the MDCN portal and do our registration online. So if you log in, this page will appear. You navigate through the page, look at what we provide, profile page, annual less than 10 years, annual greater than 10 years, full registration. So let's click on profile page to upload our records. If we click on profile page, all we do is we click on the name or the email address. Then this page will appear. Let me zoom. Let's put our attention to the attachment section. This is where we upload our email address, the remitter, retriever reference receipt, the CME points, and we also upload our basic details like the address and phone number and contact address. Then let's click on attachments. When you click on attachment, we click on add. Then we locate where we have a scanned CME, which is usually 20 points. So we upload the 5 points. Then we also upload our remitter receipt. After making payment, the remitter receipt will also be uploaded. This is an example of the CME form scanned, which will be uploaded. Then we look at the edit button. When we click on edit, we need to type in our full name, our address, date of birth, then local government. Example, if your local government is not available, all you do is you click on search more and you type in your local government and upload. Upload your university, secondary school. Then upload your preclinical and clinical period with dates. Full registration information is also uploaded. Your FM number is the full medical. Your PM number is the provisional medical. If you are a dental surgeon, PD is provisional dental, FD is full dental. We should note that full registration number is different from folio number. Then you type in your employment information, like the internship is displayed here. We should take note that date of assumption of duty should be exactly with the date of termination of internship. So we are putting 1 year exactly. Current address and workplace, any other previous employments, you write. Then let's go and request for our annual practicing license. If we upload our CME points, our remitter receipt, we need to apply for our annual practicing license. So if you are a doctor less than 10 years, you click on less than 10 years or greater than 10 years if you are a doctor greater than 10 years. Type in the details, medical or dental, your full name, your folio number. Then when we are requesting, very important, we need to request from January 1st, 2017 to December 31st, 2017. So we're going to choose from 2017 to 2017. If it is 2018, January 1st, 2018 to 31st December 2018, we choose from 2018 to 2018. Once we click on the submit button, we proceed to make payment. Now we are going to classify who a doctor is, less than 10 years, at 10 years, or greater than 10 years. An example, if you graduate in 2008, it counts at 1. Then we count the number of years, 9, 10, up to 2017, you are a doctor at 10 years because you make your payment in the previous year. So the payment for 2017 license is done 31st of December 2016. So since you are paying for your annual license for 2017, you are now a doctor at 10 years. So you are now pushed to greater than 10 years, no longer less than 10 years. So take note, doctors that graduate in 2009, for the payment of this 2018 license, which will be done on or before 31st of December 2017, you should note that you have switched from a doctor less than 10 years to a doctor greater than 10 years. Recently, 2017 license is upgraded from 6,000 naira to 10,000 naira for doctors less than 10 years, and upgraded from 10,000 naira to 20,000 naira for doctors at or greater than 10 years. And we should note that we should make our payment before the end of the year. If not, it will attract a 100% fee, which is twice the value. So a doctor that is less than 10 years will end up paying 10 plus 10, that is 20,000. A doctor that is greater than 10 years will end up paying 20 plus 20, that is 40,000. So we should take note and make our payment before expiry. If we want to make payment through the council website, this is how we go about it. We add it to cart, we upload our billing details, and select our delivery method. If we are picking up at the MDCN website, we click on none. But if we want it to be shipped to America, you click on United States of America, and you will be charged postage charge. With time, this license will actually be posted directly to your practice. So looking at the local postage charge, it might be within Nigerians, within the states. You can actually click on local postage charge once it is approved, and then your license can be posted without physically coming to the council. Then we now click on remitter, which is the payment method, and we proceed to the remitter website. Remitter website is www.remitter.net. We are going to look at pay a federal government agency. Click on it. Then, the name of ministry, department, and agency, we will start typing medical and dental. Once you type medical and dental, the account number will come out in full. All you do is click. Then we select the purpose, which is practicing fee. The name of the payer should be in full with his folio number in bracket, because that is your ID number. Then you type in the amount without pressing comma. 10,000. For less than 10 years, or 20,000 for greater than 10 years. Then we qualify the description of what we are paying for. Annual practicing fee less than 10 years, or annual practicing fee greater than 10 years. For doctors that are paying late registration, they should also qualify annual practicing fee less than 10 years plus late registration for previous year. Then we should note that the full name is needed, your active email address, and your phone number. Then we type in the CAPTCHA secure code. Then we will proceed to make payments. This is the page that will appear. We have payment options include VAV, MasterCard, or Visa. We also have the remitter retrieval reference, which is very important in monitoring your payment and getting your receipt. So let's click on MasterCard and Visa card, and let's also see how our cards are. We should note that every card has a 16-digit card number, as outlined, an expiry date, the name as it appears on the card, the type of card, is it a Visa card, is it a VAV card, or is it a MasterCard? Then we should also note that we need OTP tokens, which are one-time password devices, during the course of the registration, whereby we will press, it will generate codes, and we complete our registration. Some OTPs can also be posted to your phone number. So let's go back to our page, and here we are going to either select MasterCard or Visa cards. Anyone we click, this page, taking note of the RRR number, then clicking on either VAV, MasterCard, or Visa. So for reference, I'll click on MasterCard and Visa. This page will appear. Type in 16-digit card number. CV code is the last 3 digits at the back of the card. Then name of the card holder as it appears on the card. The expiry date, month, and year. Then we click on OK. If you are using a MasterCard, a secure code will appear. All you need is click on Receive One-Time Password via Registered Phone Number, or click with your hardware token. Then you acknowledge the button and click on Submit. When we submit, the OTP code will be text to the phone number and email address. We type in that 6-digit example, 123456, and we click on Submit. Once we click on Submit, our payment will be captured and it will be approved. For Visa, we all know about iPIN. iPIN is generated when you visit your Visa card ATM. Then you generate an iPIN by clicking on Change iPIN. Not the change PIN as usual, but Change iPIN, because for a Visa card, you need an iPIN to be able to transact online. So we will type in our iPIN, let's say 1234. Then we click on Submit and our payment will be captured. For those that are making payments with Access, for example, we have another second level verification, which will require an OTP by email or by phone. If you're outside the country and you don't have access to phone, you select email as your OTP delivery option. But if you are within the country and your phone is on, you use the phone number. So when we type, our payment will be processed. Coming back to the same page, let's look at VAV. If you want to make payment with VAV, you click on the VAV icon, taking note of your RRR number. Then we click on Proceed. The InterSwitch WebPay will appear. Type in card number, expiry date, CV code, the last 3 digits at the back, and the card PIN. In this case, we are using the card PIN, the same PIN we use when we are withdrawing money from the ATM. After that, we click on Pay. Upon completion of payment, PDF receipt will be sent to your inbox like this. The one with the barcode is your remitter retrieval receipt, which you can use to apply for your exams or pursue to collect your full registration or annual license. So let's take note our barcode receipt. Now, coming to young doctors who graduate, we all know that we collect our provisional license, which is for 2 years, whereby you are supposed to complete your 1 year internship. Then during attestation, you will be given the provisional registration certificate and then 1 annual license certificate. Upon completion of your housemanship or internship, you will now get ready to process your full registration certificate, whereby you will be notified of your collection points. Is it Abuja, Enugu, Kaduna? If your package is in Kaduna but you stay in Abuja, there is a way you can make an application so that it will be returned from Kaduna branch back to the Abuja main branch for easy collection, or from Lagos branch back to Abuja branch for easy collection. This is our remitter receipt again, whereby we pay a local postage charge for this certificate to be returned from another branch. So you can see we don't even need to physically travel to Kaduna. You can actually make a payment and by post, it will be returned and you easily pick up at the headquarters. Then, after that, we collect our full registration. Unlike provisional certificates, full registration is full-time. The provisional is expired upon collection of full registration, and now as a doctor, you are you are on your own. But provisional registration, you are supposed to be guided and under the mentorship of your consultants and under an accredited teaching institution. Following collection of full registration, you also collect your annual license. The first annual license comes with your certificate of provisional registration. The second one, you also collect it upon completion of housemanship and about to go for NYSC. So at this point, doctors that are NYSC will start attending continuing medical education to get their 20 points, which is needed for collection of subsequent annual practicing licenses. So like this doctor, we can see that this is license for 2015, license for 2016, and license for 2017. We should note that the CME lectures we attend for 2017 will be used to renew license for 2018. And this CME point should be spread across all the quarters of the year and preferably from different continuous professional development associations like the Nigerian Medical Association, the Nigerian Dental Association, the National Postgraduate Medical College, and should be spread across the quarters of the year. Thank you very much.